Victorians owe nearly $1 billion in unpaid fines, but the state government isn't chasing the money. Heidi Murphy joins me now. Heidi, it's an eye-watering amount of missing money.
Yeah, that's right, Pete. Our Nine News investigation has found there's well over $800 million that could be paying for more police, teachers, pothole repairs right now if the government got serious about cracking down on outstanding fines. But these documents we've obtained through Freedom of Information also show the government appears to be losing interest in trying to collect it.
Plenty of fines are being issued, they're just not all being paid.
That sends a shocking message, a message of unaccountability.
Documents obtained exclusively by Nine News show a record $867 million is owed. $353 million is for speeding fines, $276 million is in tolling fines, $111 million for parking infringements, $77 million in court penalties and $50 million in red light camera fines.
No, I'm not.
Neither are road safety advocates.
People just going, well, I might have got a fine, but I haven't paid it, so nothing bad's happened. So they just carry on, and in fact, it probably ramps up more poor behaviour because people don't think that there's an actual consequence to it.
The Attorney General is blaming some of the backlog on the pandemic.
We took a very empathetic response to fine recoupment during COVID, for example. So a lot of the sheriff's work is now picking up.
The government is chasing up fewer offenders. The number of notices of final demand being sent has more than halved.
Go after it, because that money will make a difference.
It's money that could fund 11,000 more police or teachers, 10,000 more nurses, more than 50 new primary schools, or even half of a major new hospital.
If those fines were collected, we wouldn't have a health tax, we wouldn't have a tourism tax, we wouldn't have a schools tax.
Collection methods used interstate include giving body-worn cameras and FPOS machines to their fine compliance teams.
To recover what is owed to the people of Queensland.
But it's a method that won't be coming south.
I think it's highly, highly unlikely. There's no advice to do what's happened in other states.
Heidi Murphy, Nine News.